Hello guys, this is Revan from Digital Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 86. WhatsApp is one of the best applications for free instant messaging, and the platform is in use of millions of people from around the world who rely on it for communication and socialization with their friends and their families. The messaging giant realizes the big impact it holds in the lives of so many, and hence the company works very hard day in and out to provide their customers with the best possible features. The company launches a new and unique tools every now and then, and also updates its previous features frequently. Starting from this week, WhatsApp is rolling out another new feature, which is called the new archive. The company has updated this feature through the Google Play Store beta program, and this will be available in the version 2.21 onwards, but to only some specific Android 11 users currently, as reported by BBOM. Battlegrounds Mobile India, the rebranded version of PUBG Mobile India, has undoubtedly become the most awaited game right now. Ever since Krafton has announced the arrival of the game in India, it is safe to say that people are looking forward to the launch date, which is yet to be revealed. It is presently up for pre-registration on the Google Play Store. However, it seems like people are trying to take an advantage of people's excitement, due to which there are a number of fake Battlegrounds Mobile applications that have surfaced on the Google App Store. It is revealed that if you search for Battlegrounds Mobile India on the Google Play Store, multiple apps will appear, which can confuse people. However, you should know that these applications are fake, while some claim to be a game guides and other prove to be totally different application that is trying to cash it on the game popularity that has grown exponentially these days. OnePlus is announcing that it will extend the warranty till June 30 on all its products in India, whose warranty is expiring between April 1 and June 29, 2021. The announcement comes amidst that ongoing COVID-19 crisis in the country. OnePlus also extended the warranty on its devices last year, owing its similar situation regarding COVID-19. Many companies have also announced that they have extended the warranty for its smartphone and other devices. OnePlus mentioned that it will update its customers if there is a change in the policies or its operations. OnePlus TV 40 Y1 is confirmed to launch in India in the coming week. The 40-inch TV will be an additional to the OnePlus TV 32 Y1 and OnePlus TV 43 Y1 models available in the country. The upcoming OnePlus TV 40 Y1 will sit in between these two already launched TV models and should be priced accordingly. It will likely to be positioned at the slightly cheaper price tag than OnePlus TV 43 Y1 that is currently priced in India at ₹26,999 on the company's website. OnePlus announced the OnePlus 9R alongside with OnePlus 9 and OnePlus 9 Pro in India in March. In the next month, the series was made officially in China soon after its Chinese launch. A digital blogger claimed through Weibo that the OnePlus 9R will soon arrive in new green color. Today, the company officially introduced OnePlus 9R's green variant. Its pre-sale will begin on May 24 in China. Snap International Company, the company behind the Snapchat, has launched its fourth-generation spectacles. This model features a full augmented reality functionality that blends filters, effects, and games from Snapchat with the real world. The new spectacles have the cyberpunk design with a bulky frame to hold all the tech on your face. We are talking about dual 3D waveguide displays, two cameras, four microphones, and two stereo speakers, and touchpad for controlling the interface. These spectacles are capable of detecting objects and surfaces using two cameras and then using that information to replace the AR effects in the world. It can detect things like, for example, your hand in a demo showed an augmented reality butterfly land on the hand of Snap CEO Evan Spiegel, and he showed off the glasses. Of course, the main purpose of the camera is being able to capture videos and photos and then share it with your friends on Snapchat. You can do all these things using this touchpad on the side of the glasses, or even use your voice to command to built-in voice assistant. While all of this indeed very interesting, Snap is actually not yet ready to start selling these particular glasses to the consumer. Instead, they will provide to select AR artists and developers who are already working on similar projects to help develop this product further and come up with other applications for it using the company's Lens Studio software. Microsoft announced the official end of Internet Explorer. We now have an official date for the death of Internet Explorer on most versions of Windows 10, and its formally replacement by Microsoft's Chromium-based browser Edge. The iPhone 12 was a best-selling phone in quarter 1 by number of units sold. The iPhone 12 Pro Max came in second. However, looking at the revenue, they generated the two Apple devices switch places. This comes from the latest report by Counterpoint Research, which notes that this quarter 1 was a record-setting quarter with over $100 billion in revenue generated by smartphones. As expected, high-end devices made the most money. Models costing $400 and up account for 65% of the global revenue. The top 10 devices users in the image below for 46% of the global revenue, yet make up only 21% of the units sold. More revelations has been made in the ongoing trial between Epic Games and Apple. Today, Michael Schmidt, head of games business development for the Apple App Store, gave his testimony. In a Bloomberg report, Schmidt was quoted to have said that during the 2 years before Apple removed Fortnite from the App Store in 2020, the game grossed $100 million for the US tech giant through commissions. The fine details of the dynamics that yielded that said amount to Apple and the exact figure were left out by Schmidt in the testimony. However, when he asked whether Apple made over $200 million from the game, Schmidt responded that it would be inappropriate for him to answer the specific questions. Huawei, the China-based tech giant, has filed a new patent application for a method and a device for automatic parking interaction that has a publication number CN11282418-3A. The patent summary describes an automatic parking interactive method provided by the embodiments of this application that is applied to a smart car, which can improve the user's interactive experience and convenience for parking. The ASUS ZenFone 8 is headed to India. ASUS has launched a landing page for the phone, while the page just call it new phone. We think it will trade under the 8Z name. The reason previous ZenFones adapted the Z naming is that an Indian company owns a Zen and Zen Mobile trademark, which lead to local court to bar ASUS from using the ZenFone name as it could confuse consumers. In March, Nubia's Gaming Wing launched the Red Magic 6 and Red Magic 6 Pro powered by Snapdragon 888 mobile platform. The company took it to Weibo handle to confirm that it will be launching a new phone called the Red Magic 6R at 3 PM on May 27 in China. Tecno launched its new smartphone in the Spark 7 series known as the Tecno Spark 7 Pro globally last month. The device is the third smartphone in the Spark 7 series as the brand has launched a Spark 7 and Spark 7P previously. Now the company has confirmed the launch of the Tecno Spark 7 Pro for the Indian market. The Tecno Spark 7 Pro will be launching in India on May 25th. Oppo is preparing for the Reno 6 series for a launch at the end of the May, and ahead of the announcement, details have been leaked. The new information includes some specifications along with renders that gives us a good look at three different models. Eventblast shared images of the Reno 6, 6 Pro and 6 Pro Plus, showcasing the different designs in the new series from Oppo. The image allies the entry model will feature an iPhone 12-like design with flat edges. The 6.55-inch Full HD Plus display features SIM bezels and a hole punch for the front-facing camera. There is a chin, but it is very minimal. The Redmi Note 8 is one of the most popular models in the Redmi Note series. It is so popular that Xiaomi is bringing it back this year with upgraded internals, and the Redmi Note 8 2021 is coming. A tweet by the official Xiaomi account has confirmed earlier reports that there is a new version of the Redmi Note 8 coming, and it will launch as a Redmi Note 8 2021. This is unusual considering that Redmi Note 8 has already received two successors, the Redmi Note 9 and the Redmi Note 10, and both are fantastic devices. There is not yet an official launch date for the Redmi Note 8 2021, but we will let you know once we do. Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 3 could come with a virtual buttons for gesture controls. The patent shows images of a Galaxy Fold-like device with touch-based keys. Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 3 is expected to launch later this year. The Mobile World Congress was one of the biggest straight face for enthusiasts in the smartphone industry. Last year, we have been surprised by an unexpected global pandemic. It forced government to push forward quarantine and isolation policies. This basically delayed most of 2020 public events. The Mobile World Congress 2020 was no exception. Now the vaccination is bringing normal life back. The public events are returning. The GSMA has just reassured its compromise in making Mobile World Congress 2021 real this year. The organizers are confident in the safety of holding the conference physically. Now the conference will happen in June. Fast rising electric vehicle maker Faraday Future is showcasing a 27-inch backseat screen with video conferencing capability added to its FF91 electric vehicle. The electric vehicle startup has endured some years of turbulence as it continues to evolve in its growth trajectory. Alphabet International Company's Google recently revealed that it would be opening its first ever physical retail store in New York City this summer. The tech giant store will be located in the city's Chesla neighborhood near its New York City campus, which houses over 11,000 employees. Google Pixel 6 CAD-based renders reveal the complete design. The handset will feature a punch-hole display and a dual rear cameras. Pixel 6 specifications include a 6.4-inch flat display, in-display fingerprint sensor, and a wireless charging port. Clubhouse Android application is now available for download worldwide. The drop-in audio chat platform was previously available only on iOS for iPhone users. The app has been making a buzz due to users looking for invites to sign in and create or join a room for voice conversations. Clubhouse confirmed the rollout of the Android app via its official Twitter account. The Android app's listing on the Google Play console confirmed that user will still need a Clubhouse invite to sign up. You can get an invite by joining the waitlist or asking for one from the existing users. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe, and follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.